Hi, welcome to the Shtick. This week we're still in conundrum about the political state of the nation. I was going to get Josh Frydenberg and Mark Dreyfus on, but because of what's going on, we've got another political animal. Somebody who has just run in the seat of Batman for the Equality Party, and her name is Aleph Melbourne.
That's right, Aleph Shoshana Syber.
Oh, gorgeous. Nice to see you here.
Thanks for inviting me.
You are a very interesting person.
I'll take that as a compliment.
Yeah. So I'll ask you, what's your shtick?
What's my shtick? Well, presently my shtick was that I ran for the lower house in the seat of Batman for the Australian Equality Party. And I've been in politics for almost 5 weeks.
Vintage. You are such a veteran of politics.
Yes.
And you got 500 votes.
Close to 500 votes, which is a really fantastic new start. So I'm very happy with what's been happening and what might happen as well.
Because it's a brand new party, isn't it?
That's right. Jason Toison McSheen and his crew set it up about 2.5 years ago. Looking after the LGBTIQ community of Australia. We were hoping to get Jason into the Senate. And so that there'll be a voice from within the community, within the federal politics.
And we have a common friend. His name is Michael Barnett.
Oh, Michael.
Yeah. He runs Aleph Melbourne, which looks after the Jews who are LGBTQI.
That's right, yes. And he suggested that I become...
It's all his fault.
It's all his fault. Michael Barnett! Thanks for throwing me into the deep end.
And I knew you many, many years ago in Adelaide, 35 years to be precise, when I used to be an antique dealer. And your dear father, Felix, who's now passed away, he was one of the greatest characters in the antique trade in Adelaide. He was in Unley Road, and I was a regular visitor. I used to go to Adelaide, and I met you and your brothers, Philip and David, and
That's
your
right.
dear mother, Helen.
Yes.
Used to invite me for chicken soup.
And her freshly made bread.
Oh, she was a delight. Always so friendly, such a great open home. And then a few years later, you all moved lock, stock and barrel to Melbourne.
That's right. Three of us moved, and then Mum and Dad moved after us.
And so now, in the last few years, you've transitioned as a transgender person.
That's right.
Yes. So I want to know a little bit more about that, because that's been very interesting, because I've known you for so long. I've sort of been watching this happen. It's also a very private affair. So there are certain things I won't ask you, but you were married for how many years?
Married for quite a few years, and I have three beautiful children.
Mm-hmm.
And during the marriage, my gender dysphoria was known to them. To my ex-wife.
Abigail.
That's right. And I used to be able to go out as a part-time Liz and express myself as myself.
So this goes way back before your marriage.
Oh, you already, absolutely.
From the age of 11, apparently.
That's right.
You already knew that you were...
That's right.
Hetsy.
Well, in a way, just gender dysphoria is a condition in which you aren't quite happy with the gender that you're born into.
Mm-hmm.
And so at the age of 11, I was cognizant of that. And I knew immediately I had to hide it, because I was aware of discrimination even back then, a long time ago. So I hid it from my family, and I hid it from friends and the school. And so I grew up being torn. And then I decided the best avenue for me to survive was to find a life where I could live my life part-time as Liz, but also to have a family. And I was looking forward to the opportunity of doing that for the rest of my life.
And Abigail knew when you were about to get married, you disclosed that.
Yes, and then we discussed, went to counselling, how this could happen so that it was a good thing within the marriage. And so it worked until I decided to leave the marriage.
Because you had to do the full shtick.
No. I didn't leave because of this.
No?
No, I left for a completely different reason altogether. This did not influence the reason why I decided to leave the marriage. But once I left the marriage and was on my own, the gender dysphoria erupted in full.
Yep.
And so I was under psychiatric care, psychological care, went to the Monash Gender Clinic, and under great care and concern by these people, under great counselling, it worked out that I would become Liz full-time. And so 6 years ago, I stepped out of my home, closed the door, it was a wonderful day, and turned around, and my gender dysphoria disappeared.
Fantastic. So now you are fully fledged Elizabeth Shoshana Syber.
That's right.
And that's what you ran as in the Equality Party.
That's it, yes.
And that's what you're on TV as well. You are actually a TV personality.
Well,
in your own right.
I do some hosting on the Antics with Attitude, Channel 31, Wednesday 7:30. And I've got a segment called Liz's What Not.
That's fantastic. So that's on Wednesday nights at 7:30 on Channel 31.
That's it, yes.
I'd never known about it, actually. I don't really watch much television, to be honest, but I've still got a keen interest in antiques, and you've become recently a member of the Antique Dealers Association of Australia?
That's it, the Australian Antique Dealers Association.
Yeah.
I think this is now my third year. I do their fairs here in Melbourne. I do their fairs in Sydney, and they're absolutely wonderful events. They've got wonderful standards.
Mm-hmm.
All antique dealers can join.
Don't they vet your items? They're 100 years old.
Oh, no, they vet the authenticity,
the authenticity of the
quality of the items. You can have things from the 1970s or 80s
really?
Of high standard.
Because in my day, it had to be 100 years old,
yes.
Strictly.
Not anymore, no.
Well, that's fantastic. And you've also got a shop in Alphington.
That's right. My brother Philip and I are still continuing on the family tradition, which started about 42 years ago. Thank you. When Mum and Dad opened up their first shop.
Was it only 42? It feels like 45. But anyway, maybe it's not that quite long.
And so anyway, thereabouts. And so Philip and I still run a shop on Heidelberg Road, Alphington, Syber's Vintage Bazaar. He specialises in contemporary vintage, which is more 20th century. And I'm still, like you were, totally eclectic.
Specialising, not specialising.
That's it.
Yeah, I made that up in 1977.
Oh, so sorry for using it.
You don't use that. That's my motto. But you can use it if you want, because I'm not dealing anymore.
Mm.
I've still got the collection. I still occasionally go out, but I never look for camels, but they find me.
Mm.
And I know Philip still does Camberwell Market.
Yes, Sunday Market. He loves that. Great atmosphere down there. And I do it occasionally too when he needs a break.
That's so good. I just love the antique trade. And I also love having old friends on the show. And you are such a wonderful, wonderful character.
Thank you.
And you're evolving. You're evolving beautifully. I think you're really fitting into your groove.
Good.
That's really great. And I wish you luck with your... whatever pursuit you have, especially in politics, I think we should, we're just about to go into the next segment with a man called Richard Moore, who was the artistic director of the Melbourne International Film Festival, has just completed the Hot Docs Festival.
Wow.
And we're going to talk to him about Mr. Gaga.
Mr. Gaga.
Yeah, which is a film about the Batsheva dance company. And it is just the most wonderful experience going to see that documentary, which you'll have to go and see.
I will, thank you.
And we'll end it here because there's so much more we can talk about, and we'll have you on as time goes by.
Good on you, Henry. Thank you very
much
for having me.
It's great. So we'll be back after the break with Richard Moore.